Hello everybody, Flip here. I managed yesterday to fly hardest day with both Germans and British, and so I thought I'm gonna make a quick review of the event. As you can see, here is the event setup. There's the German spawn point all the way in the south, the British airfield in the north, and the British spawn point, which is in the center, with a line of British destroyers, which provides quite a bit of AA cover if you can pull the enemies down. The German bombers fly from the German spawn point just into the direction of the airfield along the coast. And usually there are two major combat zones, one around the destroyers and the second one around the British base. So, let's get started. As usual, if I have the chance, I'm taking out my BF-110. I'm gonna start out here. There's one bomber spawn, as you can see, a little bit ahead, and a second behind us. So we just spawn between them, slightly underneath, with the British spawning at the same height, essentially slightly to the left of the first bomber spawn. Now we can see the dots there over Dover. To start out, I'm just need altitude as usual, so I'm using my friendly fighters as a screen and just zigzagging behind them to altitude. It's heavy fighter as usual. You want to have top cover in the beginning. You can provide it later on when you manage to climb up, because you have the fuel and the ammunition to just be longer in the fight. But initially, especially the German single engine fighters have a huge climb advantage. And also, as you will later see, the Spitfires, the MK2A in this case, is also climbing faster than the BF-110. So now we actually get some cloud cover, which is quite nice. So as soon as I'm in the clouds, I can do another turn, and hopefully if some British has spotted me, hopefully loses me. So another turn, and up we go again. And now we've reached already the 2000 mark. Still climbing really hard, all trying to just gain a little bit of speed, but mainly I'm focused on just getting altitude as fast as I can without dropping under like 250 is usually a good speed, but not under 220. It gets the airplane gets a little bit sluggish without flaps. Yeah, it's actually one of the really nice things about a BF-110 is how smooth and nice it flies at low speeds. There are other heavy fighters which behave really nasty at low speeds, but the BF-110, especially with flaps, you can fly really slow and still do really good precise maneuvers. So if the first enemies who go after our bombers, some people might know this, or most people might know this map already from patch 1.33, where the setup was quite similar, but it was only one bomber spawn, which was the spawn ahead. So, but the same amount of airplanes as far as I remember. With also AI Hurricanes helping out the British, which you will see later. However, there is a difference to the 1.33 version, because it's a lot easier to destroy the British base. We'll see this later on, that in both matches, if it would have been 1.33 hardest day, I would have lost. But in this first match, in the second match with the British later on, exactly the opposite happens. where usually we would have won the game, and this time around it was a loss. Just that a little bit ahead of time. So if this event is coming on again, the Germans definitely have the historical advantage. So now slowly gaining the advantage, and it's a little bit uncomforting for them to be like within 10k, but the ones which are closer are lower than me. And now that I have reached the 4k magical heavy fighter mark, I set myself, I actually turn and head in, picking up a little bit of speed. Usually I try, when I head into the combat area with a BF 110, to be over 275, if possible, because then the acceleration delay you just have in this airplane is not that bad, and it's also a speed where you don't shed too much, you lose too much speed with maneuvers, while doing maneuvers. Because that's one of the big disadvantages of the BF 110, it just sheds speed in maneuvers as if it had fun with it. So you always need to be very careful when moving the mouse around if you need your speed. So I'm trying to close up to these higher enemies. Oh, we had a crash there. Bam. Head on, as far as I remember. The most important bit initially is just get the energy advantage over the enemies. We want to press the Spitfires, the British, down to the sea so they can't attack our bombers. However, what happened in this match is that not just the British went down to the to the lower levels, but also quite a bunch of BF-109s. I don't know why, but everything seemed to happen down at really low levels. And I see here a few of my friendlies in a little bit of trouble, so I just try to get a, just dive in quickly, get a few shots out and get out again. But first target I choose is already too damaged, and then I see this other Spitfire, which seems to also be quite on the limp and trying to get to base. And if I'm already down here, I think let's try go for him. Pop shots, 1, 2, not a single hit, and he crashes into the cliffs of Dover. But this whole adventure has cost me quite a lot of speed. I'm not even able to make it up to 1k anymore, so I need to get out of here. There's a hurricane ahead, which is down, and I have a hurricane on my tail, which is slowly catching up. I could level out and I would be faster than him, but I need to climb. I need to have a safety margin of altitude in case I need to turn fight, or worst case, if I have to turn fight, I want to have at least a chance. At the same time, I'm trying to just close the distance with my friendlies, to just stack the odds against the enemies, and there's also still another Spitfire around them. So I rather move closer there, help out with the other Spitfire, and then we can take care of the Hurricane together. Just minimizing risk. And I definitely, the one thing I have is fuel, so I can fuzz around without having to worry too much about if I have to land or anything. I still have enough ammunition, I only had this one burst, or these few bursts, on this guy who crashed. So, slowly but surely, catching up to the Spitfire. Now that I've leveled out, the Hurricane is definitely falling back. There's an AI Hurricane above me. I'm not really sure what he's doing. If he's coming for me or if he's going for the bombers. Alright. Spitfire is chased by at least one BF-109. I'm definitely in trouble. Just want to get more separation from the Hurricane now that I have some altitude to play with. And now the Spitfire is down, I can do my loop-de-loop. Hope my friendlies help me worst case. And hope the Hurricane is stupid enough to do a head-on pass with me. And here we go. 1, 2, lucky shot. That was a really lucky shot, but with a Minengeschoss in your face, that's on the other end not a huge surprise. So yeah, BF-110 in early low level is quite deadly in head-on passes with the if it's upgraded. A little bit of a different story if you still use default, but the stealth ammunition with lots of Minengeschoss is definitely super deadly. So there was a AI Hurricane ahead of us and still an enemy Spitfire was harassing our bombers. If this would have been the old hardest day, we already would have lost. The only, like, lowest amount of bombers I've ever seen required to destroy the airfield. It's like 14 if you have a friendly one. And another head-on pass. Let's see if he's... Ah! This time I'm not getting that lucky. But most important thing, don't turn fight. It's just head-on, steaming away. I didn't have any energy advantage on me, so I should be able to just pull away from him and at least get some separation before I have to turn. And he's nice to me, turns before I even have the acquired separation, and I can turn as well and head after him. This advantage is of course now on my side, because my acceleration is by far less dramatic than his, so as you can see he's now pulling quite steeply away from me, and I also don't want to go in too much of a dive. I need the energy for when I need to dive down on somebody, or after all there is another enemy Spitfire up there which might turn around and just come for me as easy target. Overall, with the 2A and the Hurricanes with their small caliber weapon, it's not super dangerous to get shot at, but it can quite quickly get annoying, as you see later. So we have, I have two friendlies and three enemy Spitfires down there. I need to go in. There is no other way for me. The last Spitfire is up there on the bombers, but I need to help my friendlies, so I need to get in there. Here, full roll in a heavy fighter is... Yeah, don't be afraid of doing full rolls in heavy fighters rather than turning halfway. When you have rolled halfway then turn in the other direction, the mass of the fighter, the heavy fighter, is just... It's faster to turn all the way rather than half and then turn the other direction. As you can see here, I get shot quite severely, and while the airplane is going red and I'm quite slow, still I can just wobble as much as I want without actually... And saved by the bell. As I said, in 1.33 this would have been a loss and I would have been down in the sea. This last attack run wasn't necessarily the best. And 2x bonus, new skin unlocked, metal, and final blow. Not bad. Third place for me. is definitely okay. So. And single engine fighter. Unfortunately, there wasn't any bullfighters allowed, so I just thought I'm gonna take out a Spitfire. I also flew the event in the 12 machine gun Hurricane, just to try out to shoot down as many bombers as possible. But my aim is horrible, and yeah, I don't have really, on both airplanes I don't really have anything unlocked. So it was an okay game, but this one here was definitely more fun. We'll see in a little bit why. Usual game, again, as always, climb to altitude. I realize here I'm actually the furthest ahead and not the highest, so I'm just turning around, get a little bit of space, and climb to just get at least in a similar height as the highest guys on our team, which are already further ahead. Because I know the BF-109s, they will have the height advantage. But the less they have, the less speed they can develop, and the faster we hopefully can track them in the return fight. Like with the Germans, again, it's quite a similar story. The primary goal here is to press the enemy down to a low level. So in this case, our Hurricanes or whoever, whatever Spitfire wants to can take care of the bombers, because yes, we have seen we need to shoot down quite a lot of them to just have a chance of winning. If just a few make it through to the airfield, it's most likely gonna be destroyed. So lucky us here, there are actually some of the enemy players are actually in bombers, or lucky, unlucky in this case, because the base has so little health, these player bombers can make quite an impact, I have a feeling. So while most of our friendlies go try to go in for the easy kill, yeah, I don't know why I'm flying so strangely there. Yeah, I'm trying to just stick with the rest of the guys which are further up than me to support them if there's a... Ah, and there we are. As I said, the BF-109s will definitely be higher than us. So, turning around to go for the closer one. But he's actually not going for the higher Spitfire, he's going for the one lower, which already has a BF-109 on the ass. Now both of them are further away, and so I'm trying to support, like, within. You will see more of throughout this recording with this other BF-109. So again, BF-109 drops far down. I don't want to drop yet. They're all lower. There's no need yet for me to just go down there. We just want to get them down. It's the only... We don't need to sweep them down. If they drop down to the water level, we essentially have a chance to win. If they stay up here and press us down, they essentially securely can get the bombers to the base. So, and the action begins. All the BF-109s, similar as in the match with the BF-110, where also all the Germans dove down and tried to turn fight on water level. Here we have the same situation again, everybody is diving down. I don't, again, I'm not committing yet, just doing a boom and zoom. Too many of the BF-109s down there, and I'm... Yeah, I haven't flown the Spitfire enough, so I'm not entirely sure at this point how good I can outturn them. Now I'm instead of going for the lower ones, I'm just going for the highest enemy, just the BF-110, get a few shots on him, and again do the same. I'm not committing yet, taking my speed, just boom in a Spitfire, just to be safe. Keeping an eye on him, because he looked like he definitely didn't like me. But indeed, he's pulling up and slowly stalling out. So the only thing I have to do, turn it, fight the camera, and get another few shots into him. Again, fully vertical, no need to turn fight yet. Right, I know all the other BF-109s are down, so at some point we have to do it. Get a few more shots on him, and join the fray. Primary goal here was for me not necessary to shoot anybody down, but I just didn't want any of the BF-109s to gain altitude again. I just shoot them, get them down, keep the energy as much as I could. Next one. Just don't lose the speed. They've already spent all the energy. If I spend my energy now on one of them, another one might be able to turn around and go for me. He's going down. Just at least dropping energy again. Next one who's trying to gain some energy. And again, target switch. Okay, here's the guy I earlier shot at. He isn't entirely done yet, but again, trying to turn fight and not even went after me, so I don't know why. And Dark Within takes care of the other BF-109. And now essentially I realize this is in the bag. We just won a 4 with this 2 against BF-109s. Lucky us, or I don't know. Like I said, I don't have enough experience in the Spitfire. Dark Within is going for the other BF-109, just trying to get to land. I'm just gonna give him this kill, because firstly I have the higher energy and can build up more energy while he's going after it. So I'm in a really good position to cover him. And now that he spent his energy on killing the BF-109, I can go in and have my finish off the BF-110. He's coming in with me. He's not as nice as me apparently, but who cares? I'm just... Yeah, this was a little bit too long of a burst, but I'm not necessarily the best shot, so I just wanted to make sure, especially don't give him the kill. Alright, so still have some ammunition, lots of fuel left, and it's looking good. There are only 3 of them left. One is already, I know now, is a bomber. I'm pretty sure there's more bombers around on their side. So, but there is 11 AI bombers still left, and from last match, the BF-110, I know this will most likely mean they're able to destroy the base. So, what to do? What to do? Go for the enemies, the player enemies which are left, and try to shoot them down before the AI bombers make it to base. Or try to shoot down at least one or two more of the AI bombers and hope my teammates will do the same, so we just barely get the airbase through. Yeah, there's another bomber. And that's actually the last two left now. So, thinking both of them are quite far out. Most likely low on ammunition, but I have some left. So hopefully I can go kill an AI bomber, which isn't that far out anymore. It's anyway on the way. Land, the arm and start again. And hopefully the airbase isn't dead by then. That's the plan at least. I know it's most likely not gonna happen, but I definitely wanna have it happen after this slaughter of the BF-109s. This match needs to end well. Don't wanna lose this. So, there's one Henkel 111, which is already smoking. That's the one I wanna go for. Or I initially pick as target. It's damaged already. Hopefully a few more shots. Make destroy engine, set him on fire, anything would be nice. Okay. Just a few pop shots. And the one after the machine gunner there. Should have directly gone for the smoking one. The flap had surprisingly flap gun. It could keep the aircraft up in flight, but I had a feeling it was quite drastic and I was running out of time. So let's just try to head for the airbase as quick as possible. Didn't have any impact on the enemy bombers. There's still friendly fighters up there, so one more down. Hopefully. Okay. Let's try to land this thing. It's actually the first time I'm landing a Spitfire in a historic battle. So I'm not entirely sure the speed and so on. I'm just going here after my usual heavy fighter measures. Cut the engine just to drop as much speed as possible. As soon as I raise the flaps, put the flaps down, the airplane starts behaving really weirdly. Don't wanna give any more power, because I don't know how the airplane will behave, and especially I already have like this torque movement on it, so accelerating. No. Alright. Awkward landing and lost the mission. Alright, but still. Was fun game. Like I said, quite surprised how well I did against this swarm of BF-109s. And let's see what the result says this time. Overall, I have to say this is always quite nice event, even with the fact that you most likely, it's always a little bit unbalanced for one or the other team. But that's just, that's events for you, and I really love this on it. And as you can see here, even with losing the mission, I still managed to get quite a bit of lions here. The hit count is quite nice. And again, third place. So here, just compared quickly the two results. I hope you enjoyed the review. Have fun, fly safe, flip out.